previous class. Lens part means in the light chapter, optics part, ray optics, the sub part of the ray optics, refraction of light, and the lens completed. Any question from your side? The lens or refraction of light. Lens Mackerer formula, lens formula, magnification, power of lens, and contact of lens to find out the focal length of the lenses, and the application also, and reasoning questions also. Why the air bubble inside the water behaves like a concave lens, but it is actually the convex lens, and why you cannot see clearly when dip in water, means inside the water you cannot see it, and why the swimmers use special type of spectacles. Okay, so many reasoning questions are there. So next sub part of this chapter is the prism, glass prism. It is the glass prism. Okay, how many surfaces are there? How many surfaces are there for a glass prism? How many surfaces are there for a glass prism or a prism? You know it, the five surfaces are there. Three are the rectangular shape and two are the triangular shape. So out of three rectangular shape, one side is the base and the two sides is the reflecting surface. Okay, but the triangular sides, not the reflecting surface. Okay, so this side is the triangular shape, that side also the 3D figure, so you know it, that side is the triangular shape, this side is the rectangular, that side also rectangular, and this side also rectangular. So one is the base, another is the first reflecting surface, and next one is the second reflecting surface. Sir, second refracting surface. So when the light passes through the prism, you know it, the tracing of light, ray of light through the prism from your previous class. Okay, you know the diagram for the light passes through the prism. Nobody is here. So delta equal to I1 plus I2 minus A. So I1 plus I2 minus A, and this is the angle of incidence, that is the angle of emergence, and that is the angle of refraction, that also the refraction for the denser medium. You know it, this is the angle of prism. So how can I prove it? How can I prove it? So how can I prove it? Delta equal to I1 plus I2 minus E. Suppose you consider it. First you consider it. A, Q, O, R is a rectangle. Okay. Angle of A plus angle of Q plus angle of O plus angle of R equal to 360. So you know it. Angle of Q equal to angle of R equal to 90 degree. Normal. So angle of A plus angle of O equal to 180 degree. This is the first equation. For the second equation, suppose you consider it, QOR is a triangle. So QR open plus R O Q angle plus R Q O angle equal to 180. Okay, that means R2 plus angle of O plus R1 equal to 180. Clear? R1 plus R2 plus angle of O equal to 108. Okay. Next part. This is I1. Okay. The value of delta. This angle will be I1 minus R1. That angle will be I2 minus R2. So delta. Delta is the exterior angle of the triangle PQRS. Delta is the exterior angle of the triangle QRS. So delta equal to angle of SQR plus angle of SRQ. Okay. SQR equal to I1 minus R1, I2 minus R2. Therefore, I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. So, my dear student, you check here from equation 1 and equation 2. Equation 1 and equation 2. From equation 1 and 2. Equation 1 and 2. You check it. R1 plus R2 equal to A. From equation 1 and 2, this equation and that equation, 180 degree both are equal. So, R1 plus R2 plus angle of O equal to A plus O. O cancel. So, R1 plus R2 equal to angle of A. That reason, we can write here, this is the value of delta. So, angle of deviation delta equal to I1 plus I2 minus A. So, the angle of deviation delta equal to I1 plus I2 minus A. And if you try to draw the graph I delta in your practicals also, I delta, what will be the nature of the graph? And you can find out the minimum deviation for a particular prism. How it is possible and how you can draw it? Suppose you see here, this is the relation between the angle of deviation with the angle of incidence and the emergent angle, I1 and I2. A is fixed, you know it. So, it depends on the two factor, I1 and I2. You can calculate it. The value of I1 and I2 with the help of the protector for a particular ray of light, you can easily calculate it. And if you plot the graph, I1 and I2, that time delta along this direction means y axis. And the incident ray and the emergent ray along that direction. Okay. If you put it I1 and I2 value, that time you see the nature of the graph is this. Okay. Nature of the graph is this. Means if you consider this side is I1, that side is I2, if I1 is increased, suppose I1 is increased, that time you see I2 is decreased from your practical hand. If I1 is increased, this side is increased, I2 will be the decrease. At the point here, when I1 equal to I2, that time the delta will be minimum. This is called the minimum deviation. This point is the delta M. Delta minimum. What is this necessary condition? When I1 equal to I2. That means I1 minus I2 equal to 0, that time the delta W means delta M, the minimum deviation for that particular prism. This is also your practical. Okay. The I delta graph, from the I delta graph, you can calculate it, you can draw it, you can find out it. The minimum deviation of that particular prism. Okay, next, for the minimum deviation condition, you can find out the refractive index of the prism, that means the glass. You know it, n equal to sin I by sin R. Okay. From the Snell law, you know it, the refractive index of the glass with respect to here, that is equal to sin I by sin R. Here you write here sin I1 by sin of R1. Sin I1 by sin of R1. What will be the value of I1 and R1? You know it. For the minimum deviation, delta M, what will be its condition? I1 equal to I2. So I1 equal to I2, that value will be the I1 plus I1 minus A. So the value of I1 will be delta M plus A by 2. If I1 equal to I2, that time you can write it R1 equal to R2. How can we write it? You see here, N equal to sine of I1 by sine of, sine of R1 equal to sine of I2 by sine of R2. Okay, yes or no? Sine of I1 by sine of R1 equal to sine of I2 by sine of R2. Why you can write it? Because refractive index of glass with respect to air. So it will be the reverse. You know it. For the minimum deviation condition, you know it, I1 equal to I2. So this cancel to each other. Sine of R1 equal to sine of R2. Okay, R1 equal to R2. Am I clear? That time R1 equal to R2. You know it. A equal to R1 plus R2. So R1 equal to A by 2. So you put it here. The formula is sine of delta M plus A by 2 by sine of A by 2. So this is the formula for the refractive index of the glass prism. You can calculate it with the help of minimum deviation of the prism. So any question from your side? No one students present in the class, so no questions. I am the hero in this class, no mistakes, because you are not here. So many mistakes are here. If you try to interact the teachers, that time it will be better. There are no interaction, no questions. So no interest to the students. Next part, the delta M. Okay. So two formulas, you know it. One is the delta equal to I1 plus I2 minus A. Second is delta M. From the delta M condition, you know it, I1 equal to I2 and R1 equal to R2. For this condition, you can find out the value of refractive index sine of delta M plus A by 2 by sine of A by 2. Okay, if you consider a very thin prism, what will be the delta, value of a delta? Very thin prism, you can find out the value of delta. You know it, N equal to sine I1 by sine R1 equal to sine I2 by sine of R2. You know it. If you consider a very thin prism, that means I1 and R1, I2 and R2 are very, very small. According to your calculus, you know it. If this is the formula from your math, you know it. If theta tends to 0, sine theta equal to theta and cos theta equal to 1, you know it from your math class. N1 equal to I1 R1 and I2 R2. Okay. for the thin prism, when you consider the I1 and I2, R1 and R2 are very small, that time you can write it. So I1 equal to N of R1 N, I2 equal to N of R2. So my dear student, what will be the value of delta? Delta equal to I1 plus I2 minus N into R1 plus N into R2 minus A. That value will be N, R1 plus R2 minus A. Okay. So you check it. Delta equal to N into R1 plus R2 equal to A, you know it, minus A. That value will be A common N minus 1. So that value is the delta. Okay. So this is the fourth formula for this chapter. Okay. Okay, my dear student, you check it. So many questions arise from your side, but you are not present in the class. So I am very unlucky person. So next day see you again. Today up to this portion. Thank you. Thank you, my dear student.